بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I am Dr. ثناء إبراهيم, Professor of Medical Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. Today I will start with you the first biochemistry lecture in the cardiopulmonary module. The title of our lecture is Lipoprotein Metabolism. What are the objectives of our lecture? Number one is to explain the general structure of plasma lipoproteins. Number two, to understand isolation, characterization, and classification of plasma lipoproteins. Number three is to explain the metabolism of each type of plasma lipoproteins. What are lipoproteins? Lipoproteins are biochemical assembly that contains both lipids and proteins. Such a complex is formed because lipids, as you know, such as triacylglycerol, free fatty acids, and cholesterol, are hydrophobic. How such hydrophobic lipids can be circulated in the plasma? To circulate in plasma, they must form a complex with a hydrophilic molecule such as proteins, and such a complex is called lipoproteins, to be able to be transported in the aqueous medium of the plasma. There are several types of plasma lipoproteins. They are isolated and identified and are given names. The first type is called chylomicrons. Chylomicrons are synthesized in the intestinal mucosa and are carrying exogenous or dietary lipids, lipids taken in diet. The lipid taken in diet is absorbed from the small intestine, and in the intestinal mucosa, they form a complex called chylomicrons. Then chylomicrons are transported to the plasma. Class number two is called very low density lipoproteins, abbreviated as VLDL. These molecules are synthesized in the liver and carry endogenous lipids. Lipids synthesized inside the liver is transported to the plasma in the form of VLDL. We call it endogenous lipids. The third class is the low density lipoproteins. There is another class called intermediate density lipoprotein, or IDL, but this class doesn't stay in the plasma. It's transformed immediately to LDL. So the essential class is the LDL. These are metabolic products of VLDL in plasma. This means that when VLDL is released from the liver, it is metabolized in the plasma to give first intermediate density lipoprotein, or IDL, then intermediate density lipoprotein is transformed to LDL. All this will be discussed, inshallah, in the metabolism later on. High density lipoproteins, HDL. These molecules are synthesized in liver and intestine and released to the plasma. Then carry lipids, especially cholesterol from the extrahepatic tissues to the liver. This process is called reverse cholesterol transport. It will be discussed later. All these types of lipoproteins, the four major classes, are similar to each other in structure, but differ from each other in the proportion of lipids to proteins. And it was found that increase in the lipid content will increase the size of the particle, while increase in the protein content will increase the density of the molecule. For example, chylomicrons have the highest lipid content and the lowest protein content, so it is the largest in size and the lightest, low in mass. While HDL has the highest protein content and the lowest lipid content. So it is the smallest in size and the heaviest in mass. Let's see the general structure of lipoprotein molecules. Look here to the figure. The lipoprotein molecules are spherical in shape, spheres. The sphere is formed from lipids and proteins. The lipid component of the lipoprotein particles are of two types: amphibatic lipids, such as phospholipids and cholesterol, and hydrophobic lipids, such as cholesterol esters and triacylglycerols. Amphibatic lipids, as you know from last year, an amphibatic molecule is the molecule that has both hydrophilic and hydrophobic area on the same molecule. These molecules are located on the surface. They form an external coat, cover the hydrophilic area of the amphibatic molecule of the phospholipids and the cholesterol, form the outer coat of the particle. Form the outer coat of the particle. This light blue color is phospholipids, while the orange spots are free cholesterol. They form the outer hydrophilic cover. What about this inner core? The inner core, the brown color, is formed from hydrophobic lipids, TAG and cholesterol esters. Because they are hydrophobic, they are located inside the core, covered by hydrophilic area or hydrophilic cover. What about the protein component? The protein component is located on the surface. Why? Because proteins are highly hydrophilic, so it is located on the surface. Such dark blue color, located on the cover or on the coat of the particle, because it is hydrophilic. This is the general structure of any lipoprotein particle, but they differ from each other in the proportion of lipids to protein. This figure shows the percentage of each component in the lipoprotein particle. Let's see chylomicrons. If you look to the chylomicron, you will find that lipids, the yellow color, here is yellow color, is triacylglycerol. Dark blue color is protein, light blue is phospholipids, and the orange is cholesterol and cholesterol esters. Chylomicrons has the highest lipid content in the form of TAG, 90% lipids, and only 2% protein. So it is the largest in size and the lightest in mass. Look to HDL. HDL has the highest protein content, 40%, and low lipid content, only 5%. So it is the smallest in size and heaviest in mass. While LDL and VLDL are intermediates between chylomicrons and HDL. Now, let's separate lipoproteins from the plasma. Separate the molecules, identify them and characterize them, and giving them names. We're going to isolate, identify, and name them. There are two techniques to separate lipoproteins from the plasma. The first technique is called ultracentrifugation, using an equipment called ultracentrifuge, and the second technique is called electrophoresis or agarose electrophoresis. The first technique, we can summarize it. We take the plasma in a test tube and then replace such test tube in the ultracentrifuge, leave it for some time, and then remove the tube. You will find that plasma lipoproteins are separated into layers, separate layers. from the lightest layer above to the heaviest layer down. Now we will name them from the lightest to the heaviest. The lightest molecule on the top layer is called chylomicrons. The chylomicrons are the lightest, followed by VLDL, then LDL. The heaviest layer is HDL. There are four classes named from above down: chylomicrons, VLDL, LDL, and HDL. What about this blue color? The blue color is albumin-carrying fatty acids. It is not a lipoprotein class. Only albumin carrying and transporting fatty acids in the plasma. It is very heavy and it is located on the bottom, very bottom of the tube. Now, what about agarose electrophoresis? You knew electrophoresis from the last year, and in electrophoresis, we'll use a supporting medium such as gel called agarose, and we'll take a drop of plasma and replace it on the gel at the origin. The origin is near to the negative pool. Now you replace the plasma near the origin and start electrophoresis and stop it after some times. Then stain the gel. You will find that plasma lipoproteins are separated into four bands, and the migration from the negative to the positive pool in this direction, molecules will migrate in such direction. And separation by such technique depends on charge, while separation by the ultracentrifuge depend on the density or mass of the molecule. Here, separation depends on the charge. The highly charged molecules will migrate faster. The lower charged molecule will migrate slower. So we will name them from the slowest molecule toward the fastest molecule. The slowest one will be the chylomicron. Name it the chylomicron, like in the ultracentrifuge. Chylomicron, the lightest, and the chylomicron is the slowest here in electrophoresis. Faster than chylomicron is beta lipoproteins. What is beta lipoproteins? It is the LDL. We call it in electrophoresis beta lipoproteins. Then faster than beta is the pre-beta. The pre-beta is the VLDL, and we call it pre-beta in the electrophoresis. The fastest one is the alpha lipoprotein, which is the HDL. HDL is the fastest, and we call it in electrophoresis alpha lipoprotein. So the technique of ultra centrifugation separates depending on density or mass, and the technique of electrophoresis separates depending on the charge of the molecule. What about the protein part of the lipoprotein particles, the protein components? The protein components of the lipoprotein particles are called apoproteins or apolipoproteins or ABO. We can give them any of the names. They are classified alphabetical from A through E. Apoprotein A, apoprotein B, C, D, and E. Apoprotein A. Apoprotein A, there are two subclasses, A1 and A2. This is the principal protein in HDL. And beside being a component of the molecule, one of them, which is apoprotein A1, acts as an activator to an enzyme called lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase, or LCAT, lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase. Apoprotein B, there are two types of apoprotein B. B48 This is found only in chylomicrons, and B100 is the principal protein in LDL. Apoprotein C, there are three subclasses, C1, C2, and C3. Found in chylomicrons, VLDL and HDL. Originally, they are in HDL, then transported to other particles. Here, apoprotein C2 activates an enzyme called lipoprotein lipase, acts as an enzyme activator. A1 activates LCAT, and C2 activates lipoprotein lipase enzyme. Apoprotein D is found in HDL and also called cholesterol ester transfer protein, cholesterol ester transfer protein, CETP. I want you to remember such a protein because we will mention it in the last slide, so remember it. Apoprotein E is found in chylomicrons, VLDL, intermediate density lipoprotein, and HDL, originally in HDL, then transferred to the other molecules. All these proteins or apoproteins are synthesized in the liver except apoprotein B48, which is synthesized in the intestine because it enters in structure of chylomicrons. What are the functions of apolipoproteins? Number one, they are essential component in the lipoprotein to transport lipids in aqueous plasma. Number two, some of them activates enzyme. Some of them activate enzymes, such as LCAT activated by ApoA1, and ApoC2 activates lipoprotein lipase. The third importance, very important. Some of the apoproteins recognize and bind to cell surface receptors because lipoprotein particles finally must be taken by tissues to be completely metabolized. How the lipoprotein identifies the tissues? They can identify the tissues by binding to specific cell surface receptors. Some of the apoproteins help the lipoprotein to identify and bind to cell surface receptors. Let's discuss the metabolism in detail of each molecule of lipoproteins. We'll start by metabolism of chylomicrons, and I will discuss the metabolism of the molecule on the figure. Everything I will say on the figure is written on the text, but it is more easier to explain it on the figure, and it is more easier for you to understand by explaining on the figure. If you have the hard copy of the lecture, you can write notes on the figure, and later on you can study from the figure. This figure shows in detail the chylomicron metabolism. Chylomicrons carry exogenous or dietary lipids and are synthesized in the intestinal mucosa. These are the nascent or new chylomicron that carry dietary lipids and synthesized in the intestinal mucosa. This is its structure. Core formed from TAG and the cholesterol ester, and the cover formed from phospholipids with the apoprotein B48 specific for chylomicrons. Then chylomicrons, the nascent, is transported to the plasma. In the plasma, apoprotein C2 and apoprotein E is transferred from HDL, which is present always in the plasma, to the surface of the chylomicron. C2 and E transferred from HDL to the surface of the chylomicron, forming what's called mature chylomicron. The mature chylomicron is formed from a core of TAG and the cholesterol ester and a cover of phospholipids and three types now of apoprotein. The original one, ApoB48, then ApoC2 and ApoE transferred from HDL. then the molecules are transferred to peripheral tissues. In the capillary of the peripheral tissues, there is an enzyme called lipoprotein lipase, which is activated by apoprotein C2. This enzyme causes hydrolysis of most of the tag in the core of the chylomicron. 90% of the tag in the core is hydrolyzed by lipoprotein lipase to give free fatty acids that enter the tissue and glycerol, which is taken to the liver. Then chylomicron, after breaking of most of the tag in the core, is transformed to what is called chylomicron remnants. After transferring back ApoC2 to HDL, then chylomicron remnants is formed from core of cholesterol ester and tang and a coat of phospholipids, and on the surface remains just two proteins, apoprotein 48 and apoprotein E. This is called chylomicron remnants. The chylomicron remnant is finally taken up by the liver cells by endocytosis. It identifies a specific receptor on hepatocytes by apoprotein E, and then taken up by endocytosis and complete its metabolism inside the liver. This slide is very interesting. It was found that after heavy fatty meal, our plasma gets turbid. This is a sample of plasma after heavy fatty meal. It gets turbid. Such turbidity is due to the presence of chylomicrons in the plasma. The plasma becomes turbid. But after sometimes 1 or 2 hours, the plasma becomes clear. Why? Because lipoprotein lipase enzyme hydrolyze the tag of chylomicrons, transforming it into chylomicron remnants, which is taken up by the liver, removed from the plasma, and the plasma becomes clear. So we call lipoprotein lipase the clearing factor. It transforms the plasma from turbid to clear by removal of chylomicrons. Let's see the metabolism of VLDL. We'll discuss it on the figure 2. It is very similar to chylomicron metabolism, but here VLDL carry endogenous lipids synthesized in the liver. This is the nascent VLDL formed inside the liver. It is formed from a core of tag and cholesterol ester, cover of phospholipids, and a coat, a protein code called apoprotein B100, specific for VLDL. Then nascent VLDL or new VLDL is transported to the plasma, and exactly similar to chylomicron, apoprotein C2 and apoprotein E is transferred from HDL to the surface of the VLDL, forming the mature VLDL. This is the mature VLDL, has 3 apoproteins on the surface, ApoB100, ApoE, and ApoC2. At the capillary of the peripheral tissues, lipoprotein lipase that requires C2 as a cofactor will hydrolyze tag in the core, releasing free fatty acids and glycerol. Then the molecule gets smaller. We call it intermediate density IDL lipoprotein. Intermediate density lipoprotein, 50% of it is taken up by the liver, and the other 50% is transformed to LDL by giving back or transferring back C2 and E to HDL. After transferring C2 and E to HDL, IDL is transformed to LDL. This is the LDL, containing only one apoprotein, which is apoprotein 100. LDL is finally taken up through a receptor in the extrahepatic tissue to be completely metabolized in the extrahepatic tissue. So LDL carries lipid from the liver to the extrahepatic tissues. We call it LDLs, funny, it's called the bad particle because it transports lipids including cholesterol to the extrahepatic tissues, including the wall of the blood vessels, the endothelium of the blood vessels, and the cholesterol can be deposited on such a wall, causing atherosclerosis. So we call it the bad particle. And such particle has the highest cholesterol content between the different lipoproteins. It has the highest cholesterol content followed by the HDL. The highest content in LDL, then the HDL. We call the HDL good particle, but we call LDL the bad particle. Let's discuss the metabolism of HDL. Nascent HDL is released from the intestine and the liver. And it is oval in shape, discoid, oval, not sphere. The nascent is discoid, formed from core of TAG and cholesterol ester and a cover of phospholipids with apoprotein C, E, and A. Here is A1 is mentioned because it is a cofactor for ligand, but A1 and A2 are present on the surface of such nascent HDL. Then HDL is transferred to the peripheral tissues. At the peripheral tissues, the nascent HDL comes in contact with a protein here called ABCA1 protein, ATP binding cassette transporter A1. It's a very long name, difficult name, and its abbreviation is ABCA1. This protein is very important, the gray color, this protein. It comes in contact with the nascent HDL and transfer cholesterol ester. It collects and transfer cholesterol, free cholesterol. This is free cholesterol. It transfers free cholesterol from peripheral tissues to the surface of the HDL molecule. Here, the surface of HDL molecule will be covered by large amount of free cholesterol. Free cholesterol on the surface, and there is phospholipids also on the surface, and there is the LCAT enzyme on the surface. Then a reaction takes place. Such a reaction. Look here. Look to this equation. This reaction takes place on the surface of the nascent HDL. Cholesterol interacts with phospholipids. Lecithin is a phospholipid. To form cholesterol ester and lysolecithin. The enzyme is LCAT, lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase. It transfers a fatty acids from lecithin to cholesterol, forming cholesterol ester and lysolecithin. Lysolecithin is released to the blood. What concerns us is the cholesterol ester. Cholesterol esters are formed on the surface, but cannot stay on the surface because it is hydrophobic. So it is transferred to the core of the particle. Cholesterol esters are transferred from the surface to the core of the particle. So the particle is transformed to a sphere because it is now full of cholesterol ester in the core. And we call it HDL3. Such enzyme is very important to transform cholesterol, free cholesterol, to cholesterol ester, and this enzyme is activated by ApoA1. Now the process continues. LCAT continue to act on free cholesterol on the surface and transform it into cholesterol ester, going to the core of the particle, and the particle becomes HDL2. Then HDL2 is taken up to the hepatocytes, to the liver, through a specific receptor on the hepatocytes to complete its metabolism and to release cholesterol in the liver to be excreted in bile. So it is good particle. It collects كوليسترول فري كوليسترول في البريفرال تيشوز ترانسفورمينج ات انتو كوليسترول استر ريليزينج ات انتو ذا ليفر تو بي اكسكريتد ان باين. ذس از كولد ريفرس كوليسترول ترانسبورت اند از فيري اسينشال تو جيت ريد اوف كوليسترول فروم اور بادي ثرو بايل. But before uptake of HDL2 by the liver cells, there is an exchange reaction here that occurs between HDL and LDL and intermediate density lipoproteins. HDL gives cholesterol ester to LDL and intermediate density lipoprotein in exchange of TAG, which is transferred from LDL and intermediate density lipoprotein to HDL. So LDL becomes rich in cholesterol esters. LDL become rich in cholesterol esters and it transfers it to extrahepatic tissues, bad particle. This is an exchange reaction, and the protein that carries such process is called cholesterol ester transfer protein. I told you to remember it because it will be mentioned in the last slide, and this is the last slide. Cholesterol ester transfer protein, who knows its other name? It's apoprotein D. Apoprotein D. It causes the exchange reaction between HDL and LDL. HDL transfers cholesterol ester to LDL in exchange with TAG and phospholipids from LDL to HDL. This is the cholesterol ester transfer protein, CETP or ABO-D. This is the end. Thank you very much.